Hello students, good morning. So I have taught you on Friday this topic, that is set theory. I introduced that and I told you there are sets are represented in two ways. One is roster form, one is set builder form. About the roster form and set builder form, in further, in future, we will do problems based on that. But I had given you what is exactly we called as roster form and set builder form. Okay, on Saturday you wrote exam based on logarithms, wavy curve method, modulus. So again, in the next Saturday I am going to give another test, prepare for that. And let's see here, now today we are going to discuss about types of sets. And now I will speak the definitions, I will not write on the board any definition. And I already prepared the PPT for this sets theory, all the definitions and examples that I will post in the group. Using that you can just note down that, write the notes. Right now I am going to explain you what is set theory, what are the types of sets are there. I will just explain, you just listen it. Now the first thing is, in types of sets, the first one is empty set. What is that? Empty set. What is empty set? Empty set means which is containing nothing in that. So a set which is containing nothing in that, or a set which has no element in this, is called empty set. It is also called as void set. It is also called as null set. See, if I am saying one example, the set of students who are studying in class 11 of the age 78, I said as of the age 78. So no one will study in 78 age. They won't study. They don't go for the class 11 and they won't study. So that is null set. For example, I gave you. Null set means empty. Empty. Nothing is there in the set. That is called null set. So what I want to say here, for example, the void set. Null set, void set, and empty set, meaning is same. So one more example I'll give you. The set of natural numbers between 1 and 2, I said as the set of natural numbers between 1 and 2. 1 and 2 numbers, in between there is no natural numbers. So that is an empty set. Are you getting it? So if I say as a quadratic equation I took x square minus x plus 1. Okay, I took this one. The solution of the real solution of x square minus x plus 1 equal to 0. There is no real solution for this one. This is about here imaginary solution. So what is the solution of the set? The solution of x square minus x plus 1 equal to 0. It means there is no solution for this one. So it is an empty set. There is no solution for this. So we can say it is empty set. For example, I say x square is equal to minus 5. Solution of x square equal to minus 5. If I say solution of x square equal to minus 5 is, for this one there is no solution, because square root of negative number is imaginary, there is no solution. So according to this, x is equal to pi, null set. So null sets are represented by the symbol pi. Okay, this is for symbolical form for the null set. So if I say an example, R is null set, x is such that x is in between of 1 and 2, x is a natural number. If I say natural number between 1 and 2, there is no natural number between 1 and 2. So it is an empty set. Empty set means nothing containing in that. That is called empty set, void set, or null set. Hope you understand what is null set. Okay. Null set is represented by like this, and nothing containing this. No element containing this. A set has no element in it. It is called null set. A set has no element in it. No element. No element in it. No element in it. That is called as empty set. A set has no element in it is called as null set or empty set. So here, if I say the students who are studying class 12, the age group of 78 years or 100 years, if I say that is a set is null set or empty set. So this is what we call as empty set. Empty set represented by pi, and there is no solution for this. That is called, we use the null set. Next set thing is finite set. Finite set means a set
point. A set containing n point is called finite set. Or a set containing countable elements in it. Countable element. So if I am able to count, then it is called finite set. So I can say, suppose A is equal to, if I write as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so I have 100 I wrote. So this is, there is the end. So this set started from 1, but there is an end for this. So set which has an end, that is called a finite set. So we can count here, I can count how many are there. So in a set, if you are able to count the number of elements, that is called as finite set. The number of elements which you are going to count, that is called as finite set. Otherwise we can say another definition is, the set which has an end point is called as finite set. So this is a finite set. So B is equal to, suppose I wrote 1, 5, 7. It is a finite set because this is has end. This has an end. And I can count how many are there. That is called as finite set. Next is infinite set. Infinite set. What is, for example here, set of books in the library. If I say that set of books in the library is a finite set. Set of books, you can count in the library how many books are there. There will be having the library person having the list of the books. How many books are there in this? So it's a count, we can count them. So set of books in the library, set of natural numbers less than 100, set of whole numbers less than 1000, set of natural numbers less than lakh, 1 lakh, that is the finite set which has an end, that is called finite set. Next one is infinite set. What is infinite set? A set which has no end in it. A set which has no end, that is called infinite set. It means what I want to say, natural number set, I say natural number set n is equal to, I wrote 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and continuously I wrote infinity. So if this set has no end point, so that is called as infinite set. A set which has no end point, that is called infinite set. Natural numbers are infinite set, whole numbers are infinite, integers are infinite, rational numbers are infinite. So sets here, infinite set means a set which has no end point, that is called as infinite set. If I say generally, the number of stars on the sky, the number of stars on the sky, nobody will count, that is infinite. So that is the things which we are not able to count them. We cannot able to count them, how many are there in the set. So that are called infinite sets. Next it is equal sets. Equal sets means it is comparison between two sets. Two sets A and B, two sets A and B, two sets A and B are said to be equal sets. Two sets A and B are said to be equal sets if they have same elements. Same elements. Suppose if I say A is equal to, I have 1, 2, 3 and B is equal to, I have 1, 2, 3. If they have both elements same. See here, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. If two sets have same elements, then we can say the sets are equal. So I can write as A is equal to B. This can be written another way also. X at the top of X is less than natural numbers, X less than 4 or X less than R equal to 3. So we can write certain form. One thing is, when we can say two sets are equal, if they have same number of elements, if they have same elements, if they have same elements, then we can say they are equal sets. Suppose if I say A is equal to, I have PQ, then B also I have PQ, I can say A is equal to B because both have the same elements. If two sets have same elements, then we can say they are equal sets. They are equal sets. So we can write as A is equal to B. Cardinal set. Cardinal set means what here? Cardinal number. We can say cardinal set or cardinal number. Cardinal number. Okay. Cardinal number set. What is the meaning of cardinal number? If A is equal to, I have X, Y, Z. Tell me how many elements are there here? 1, 2, 3. So that is called as number of elements in A. The number of elements in A is 3. That is called as cardinal number. That is called as cardinal number set. So if you are able to count the number of elements in that set, that is called cardinal number set. Suppose you have X is equal to, X is a Y set. You have 1, 2, 3,
7, 10, 13. Now you have this number. Now number of x will be how much? Number of x will be, count it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 elements are there. This is called as cardinal number set. This is what we call as cardinal set. We call as cardinal number set. Number of elements contained in the set. The number of elements contained in the set, it is called as cardinal number set. Next one is equal sets. You understand there are two types of sets, that is equal set, equivalent sets. Equivalent sets. What is meaning of equivalent sets and equal sets? Equal sets. There are these equal sets I already explained to you. There are two types of sets, equivalent sets and equal sets. Equivalent sets means two, this is a comparison between two sets. A and B are two sets. A and B are two sets. The number of elements in A is equal to number of elements in B, then it is called as equivalent sets. Equivalent sets. The number of elements in A is equal to number of elements in B, we can say equivalent set. Equivalent set, equivalent. Equivalence or equivalent, you can say both. A is equal to, suppose you have x, y, z, and b is equal to, you have b is equal to 1, 2, 3. See, the number of elements in A is 3. The number of elements in B is 3. So the number of A is equal to number of B, they are all equivalences. What is the difference between equivalent and equal? Equal sets means A is equal to 1, 2, 3 is there, and B also have 1, 2, 3, no other elements. Like they have same number of elements and equal elements. Same elements. Then only they are equal sets. This is the equal sets. These are called equivalent sets. Hope you understand what is equal sets and equivalent sets. So what you have learned till now, that is empty set. Okay, we have learned empty set, that is called void set, finite set, infinite set, equivalent set, equal set, cardinal number set. This is you all. Now, singleton set. Singleton set. Singleton set. What is singleton set? Singleton set means a set which has containing only one element is called singleton set. A set which has containing only one element is called singleton set. For example, if I say even prime. Even prime. The set of even primes. The set of even primes, if I say. What are the prime numbers? Prime numbers are what? Start from 2. Prime numbers, what are they? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. These are the prime numbers. In that, what is the even number? 2. So, set of even prime is a singleton set. It is a singleton set. A set which has containing only one element, that is called as singleton set. So you have learned what? Singleton set you have learned. You learned empty set. You learned cardinal number set. You learned finite set. You learned infinite set. You have learned these many things. Now, we are entering into the second part of this one. That is subset, power set, and proper subsets in the next lecture.